In this video, I want to showcase for you some of Nunday's pieces from Ecuador because they really show the commitment to environmental care inherent in a lot of our pieces. When I got to earn a trip with Nunday to go to Ecuador in the summer of 2019, I got to see these pieces coming to life and was blown away at the commitment to a natural process. The pieces that you see here are all made from different kinds of seeds, mostly tagua seed. Also, they use pambil seed and acai seeds in their creations. Tagua seeds, in particular, come from a palm tree, and the palm tree will drop this huge pod full of seeds. These are not planted in monoculture, but rather a farmer might find a pod on the edge of his field and pass it along to a group such as Doña Moni's group. When we went into Doña Moni's home, the doorway was just covered with tagua seeds. They were everywhere. And I was so impressed to learn about the process where instead of using chemical shortcuts, they let bugs eat around the outside of these pods to release the seeds inside, and they let the seeds dry out naturally over time so that they end up with a product that is hard as a rock and also is totally natural and good for the planet. Doña Moni and her employees were up on her rooftop in an amazingly beautiful workshop where there was a cover there, but they had full view of the beautiful Andes surrounding them and fresh air. And the process went from the seed to slicing it up to the thickness that was needed. And then they used various machines to cut pieces into the shape that's required. And it might be little triangles, like on this piece, or something like the earrings that I'm wearing, the Abide earrings. These are the sundial earrings. And in fact, as I was there with other ambassadors from around the country, we saw this huge table covered in bright, beautiful turquoise beads, and we all said, "Oh my gosh, I hope those are for Nunday." And it turned out that they were. So we got to see them cutting a hole in the bead, and after Doña Moni's group is done creating the bead, they will then pass it on to a group such as Luis and Marina. Luis and Marina invited us into their home, and they were sharing with us about the very early days of their business when Luis was working in the fields up to 14 hours a day and was able to put food on the table, but not really thriving. He did say, "I have the heart of the artist, I always have," and he had a dream of growing this little business into their full-time work. And now they've been able to do that through partnership with Nunday. And in fact, they shared with us that their son has a dream of being a professional musician. He's a teenager, and through growing of their business, they're able to send him to a private school to study music and pursue his dream. What we didn't know then was that Luis is also a musician. When we went to dinner that night and we walked in, we heard live music and saw him up on stage playing with his friends this traditional Highland Quechua music from Ecuador. And as this music played and we were all dancing with Marina, I thought to myself, when he was working in the fields until 9 p.m., there was no time to be in a band. There was no time to have these gigs and explore this passion. And it was just this reminder that that is what this work is about. It is so that his family and the families of the women that they employ can all flourish. You can check out the links below to all of these pieces, as well as a link to just shop everything from Ecuador.